concerned, they are quite happy to see the to tax to give a tax relief to the corporations and to the very rich at the expense of public services generally. So I think what we need to do, I'll put it straight down to you. I think what we need to do is to work together, work for the return of a Labour government under a socialist Prime Minister, Jeremy Corbyn, and work young and old side by side. We are there to support you in the same way that you are there to support us. And I'd like to finish to paraphrase Lenin, if you like, but what he said at the end of the Russian Revolution, let's move on and let's build a workers' state.
It's a beautiful stuff, don't be bored from the Daily Mail in, otherwise you'll have a field day with that puff. Don't probably think you're talking about John Lennon, mind you. I'm going to ask Alan to speak in a second. But I know Felicity Darling wants to say something about the Women's Hospital. So Felicity, when you're ready, I'm going to ask Alan to speak first, and then if you could say something. Okay, I'd like to introduce Councillor Alice Bennett, one of the councillors that have declared, and I know that twice Alice has pledged to support Jeremy Corbyn, because twice he's had to stand. So alongside those other brave councillors that are supporting Jeremy, I'd like Alice now to make a contribution.
People climbing balconies and ledges to look in windows.
job. Jeremy's broken the fog that politics often wraps itself in. And, you know, with his ridiculous notions of being kind and helping people who can't help themselves and trying to create a more equal society, that's just useless. What I enjoyed about last year's contest, other than the certainty that Jeremy would win, because that was obvious, was the fact that each candidate shifted their narrative to mimic him. To someone so useless and unelectable, they were trying to be like him, not to be like him.
Carla, for that.
It's
not linked up to Facebook, so I can't notify live.
A unity candidate does not attempt to overthrow a legitimate leader of the Labour Party, someone who's highly popular and also highly respected. I was thinking about Owen Smith. I don't know much about him. I actually knew something about Jeremy before last year, but I don't know anything about Owen Smith. And had he achieved what Jeremy had achieved in 9 months, I would consider voting for him, because it's something to consider. You know, you have to not understand your enemy, but you have to understand what people have achieved and commend them for that. But I think we know that spin and PR and all of that, and perhaps he's not the unity candidate that they're kind of putting him forward as. What we need a unity candidate that is called Jeremy Corbyn. That's the only thing.
If she could come and address the meeting about the women's hospital. And it's a really important issue, so I think we need to give time to Felicity. Felicity.
Thanks for the time. Liverpool Women's Hospital is a 20-year-old hospital with national and international acclaim for the services it provides. It has a 90%+ friends and family recommendation. It saves people's lives day in and day out. And more than that, the outcomes for Liverpool Women's Hospital helps to ameliorate the impact of extreme poverty amongst the young mothers of Liverpool. There is a real determination to see the closure of this hospital. It is tied in with everything that Alex has said about the impact of cuts and privatisation of the NHS. And only for the work of researchers in Keep Our NHS Public, even though I have followed this since March 2015, I would not know that this is a pilot area for the private provision of NHS-funded home deliveries. Now, we do think women should be able to give birth at home so long as it's safe, and we do think that those women who give birth at home should be able to transfer to a hospital if there's a problem. It's so obvious, I shouldn't even have to say it. But they have had a private company providing some of that service. Privatised providers, not NHS midwives, but private midwives, going into people's homes, and that service is now going to have its contract terminated. Three deaths, the possibility of them going bankrupt because of a legal case, and on top of that, their midwives were not trained, the midwives themselves said they were not trained, in how to deal with women who had diabetes or had epilepsy or other common conditions. It is disgusting what happened in that situation, but now they're talking about closing the hospital. They've not mentioned what they would do with gynecology, with abortion, with any of the other major genetics, any of the other major services they provide. They're talking of possibly a delivery suite in somewhere near the acute hospital, and then the neonatal babies being going to Alder Hey. Well, babies who are poorly need their mum, if nothing else, for the breast milk. And they've got to be kept together. We're not prepared to have it. So, I could talk forever on the issue of the Liverpool Women's Hospital. But let me say what we're doing. We've got, at the moment, we think we're close to 50,000 signatures, both on the electronic petition and on the paper petition. We get a fantastic response when we take it into the streets. It's really, really popular with people. On the 25th of September, the day that Labour Party conference starts, we are starting at Liverpool Women's Hospital, and we're going to march down to the waterfront to have a demonstration in favour of keeping Liverpool Women's Hospital. My local Tesco's and saw one stuck up, and I haven't put it up. I was so pleased. Get them stuck up. We're going to start producing leaflets with the demonstration details on shortly. Meanwhile, if you've got an event going on in your neighbourhood, please will you tell us via Facebook or by emailing or calling me, and we will get down there and we'll do the campaign in the area. I'm looking at Croxford. Let's get us down there, so we can actually talk to people about the importance of this. The times are changing, but they better change quick, or it's going to be our women and our babies are going to die because of this.
Thank you, Christine. It's such an important campaign. We need to support that campaign. Okay. Our last speaker is Ross Quinn. He's been involved from the outset. He's the chair of Momentum Merseyside. Ross Quinn.
Hi, I'm chair of Merseyside Momentum. I'm also a United Shops steward, and I've been a member of the Labour Party for more than 6 years, and there's a couple of things that have been really frustrating over that 6 years. And the first thing was We got a Tory government in power that managed to blame a global financial crisis in banking on a Labour Party that funded public services. And what was even more frustrating is that we had a PLP that seemed to sit there and allow them to take the blame. When the Tories come to power in 2010, the country had a debt of £960 million, but they said they had an economic strategy that was going to sort this out. They had to make tough decisions, but because we were all in this together, they were going to look after hard-working families. 6 years on, it's important to look back at that strategy. Yeah, we had £960 billion worth of debt, but with their economic strategy, their cuts, that debt has now skyrocketed to £1.7 trillion.
Did they deserve a round of applause for that?
It makes sense to borrow and invest in infrastructure, but they haven't done this. They've done the opposite. They've cancelled over 715 school construction projects. And as we really start to see the effects of global warming, instead of investing in a million climate change jobs, encouraging growth, trying to build social housing, they've cancelled 1,000 flood defence projects. So you can see why we're really struggling when we look around the Labour Party and we still hear people say that we have to prove we are like the Tories, we have to be responsible and we have to balance the economy. The Tories have not balanced the economy. They've created a mountain of debt with no solution other than to sell off everything that we own and replace a housing bubble with an even larger one. This isn't just short-term pain. Council cuts have seen the land that we own sold off. They've sold off the Royal Mail, they're privatising the NHS, they're taking the wealth of the majority and they're giving it to their friends. This is a con. They're making themselves richer. Over generations, we learned as a society that working together collectively is not just healthier and fairer, but it actually succeeds. So why are we accepting the wholesale raid on public services, the destruction of children's centres, sure start centres, adult rice fight centres, throwing people overboard? When we walk around this city, you cannot fail to see the people that are being forced through the cracks of society. Sanctions, homelessness, food banks, children living in poverty. These are not the sides. No, this is nothing new. They're the Tories, and that's what they do. But everything that they stand for should be everything we stand against. As Jeremy Corbyn is our leader. And what's happened? The PLP are now standing against him. Under Jeremy Corbyn's leadership, the Labour Party has finally been prepared to stand up and fight for an alternative. Yeah. We forced U-turns on scrapping child tax credits, on forcing schools to become academies, on cuts to personal and dependent payments, lifting restrictions on Sunday trading, on scrapping animal welfare codes to name just a few. These are what the Labour Party is supposed to do.
Also recording on another camera, so I could have played that.
When I joined the Labour Party 6 years ago, I heard the party saying that they lost touch with ordinary people. They said they wanted to listen and learn what went wrong. And what I learned in the first couple of years is what the Labour Party says and what it actually does can be two completely different things. And I was really starting to tire, but Unite released a political strategy, and for me, it was a breath of fresh air. Instead of looking to fight over Tory voters, it wanted to take Labour back to its roots. It said it was time to inspire the millions of people who'd stop voting. The millions of people who see that they have no common ground to the society. No common ground with a society that seems more comfortable kicking people down instead of helping them up. It said it was time to reach out to the millions of people that think health should be about health, education should be about education, and the utility should be publicly owned to allow people to live. These are the ideas that used to be commonly associated with the Labour Party. But when I first joined the party, what I discovered was threadbare democratic structures which were quickly shut down when people started to organise. We found the party treated with complete contempt. Just over 12 months ago, I was elected to my union's rules conference, and to be honest, I thought enough's enough. We need a new political alternative, and I was going to the conference to argue for that. But just before it, something stopped me, and it was Jeremy Corbyn standing as a lead for the leader of the Labour Party. He got on the ballot paper, and overnight, people were in control. In my workplace, week before conference, a whole thing was meeting. In that meeting, I was able to talk about public ownership, about democracy, and about socialism. But more importantly, I was able to link those ideas to a current Labour politician. And that politician was elected as our leader with a landslide. And I was across our modern society. We have to stand up and identify the system that relies on exploitation, on division, and on oppression, because those are the things that are causing that violence. But we also have to put forward a better vision of society, a socialist vision of society that Jeremy Corbyn represents, a vision where black lives matter, where your gender, your sexual orientation is not really. Make no mistake now, this is a once in a century opportunity. Reorganise the meetings, reorganise the phone banks, reorganise the elections. Let's get Jeremy Corbyn re-elected as the leader of our movement. And let's pass the bill.
Support, we need your physical support, but we also need your financial support. We know that there are multimillionaires backing Owen Smith.
Yeah, we will. That is planned.
They're taking the decision to support. And remember, there are 183,000 supporters who've been begging, stealing, and borrowing to find £25 so they can be on this. So they can make their contribution. Now, we're not asking for £25 from each of you, but what we are asking